Welcome to Shooting Stars of the Lowland, California Floristic Province. Wildly popular with wildflower watchers and noted for their delicate flowers with petals that fold backward, shooting stars are showy perennial herbs that grow from a short underground stem. They are members of the primrose family, Primulaceae, and previously constituted the genus Dodecatheon, which is now treated in the genus Primula. California has 9 species of Primula, 8 of which are shooting stars. Shooting stars occur in grasslands, shrublands, and woodlands of California. In montane regions, they grow in pine forests, in meadows, and near lake shores. In the lowland California floristic province, the 2 most commonly encountered species are Primula Clevelandii and Primula Hendersonii. Primula Clevelandii, Cleveland's shooting star, has 4 recognized varieties. The 4 varieties of Primula Clevelandii are separated by their stamen colors, anther tip shape, and geography. Consult the Jepson eFlora key to determine which of those you may have found. Primula Clevelandii, variety Clevelandii, is an important member of California's native grasslands. It often grows with stipa pulchra, purple needlegrass, the state grass of California, and with Dipterostemon capitatus, which goes by a few different common names, schoolbells, blue dicks, or blue dips. Like all shooting stars, its corolla lobes reflex, fold backward. The corolla base forms a short tube, usually white to yellow. Each corolla lobe has a thin ring of yellow at the base, followed distally by a thicker band of magenta, then an even thicker ring of yellow, and the rest is white, mostly coastal, to pinkish or magenta, mostly inland. The other lowland species in the California floristic province is Primula Hendersonii, mosquito bills or sailor caps. It is found in northern and central California, inland to the Sierra Nevada, with a disjunct population high in the San Bernardino Mountains of Southern California, in woodlands and forests below 1,900 meters. Here it is among oak woodlands north of the San Francisco Bay Area. The 2 species overlap in some areas. To tell them apart, start with the largest mature leaves. The blades of both are generally narrowed abruptly to the petiole, strongly so in Primula Hendersonii. In Primula Clevelandii, the leaf blade is more than 2 times longer than wide. In Primula Hendersonii, the leaf blade is less than 2 times longer than wide. The flowers of Primula Clevelandii and Primula Hendersonii are also slightly different. Those of Primula Clevelandii are generally larger and broader than those of Primula Hendersonii. Primula Clevelandii has 5 corolla lobes, rarely 4 or 6. The distal portion of the lobes is usually white to pinkish in coastal lowlands and magenta inland and at higher elevations. Primula Hendersonii has 4 or 5 corolla lobes, most often 4 lobes in the San Francisco Bay Area. The distal portion of the lobes is usually magenta to deep lavender, rarely white. In both, the filament tube is 1 to 4 millimeters long. The stigma is not enlarged. It's about equal to the style in width. In Primula Clevelandii, the width of the filament tube is about 3 to 4 to 5 millimeters, while that of Primula Hendersonii is narrower than about 3 millimeters. Be sure to measure multiple flowers to get a feel for this character. In Primula Clevelandii, the filament tube region is purple or black, sometimes with a yellow or white spot. In Primula Hendersonii, the filament tube region is dark maroon to black, never with a yellow or white spot. The anther connectives of both species are transversely wrinkled. In Primula Clevelandii, the anther connectives are all yellow or purple to black. In Primula Hendersonii, the anther connectives are dark maroon to black. Another feature that distinguishes the 2 species is the presence or absence of root bulblets when the plant is flowering. The key asks about root bulblets, but it isn't necessary to dig up the plants to see this feature. At anthesis, while flowers are open, Primula Hendersonii usually grows broad, white, rice-like bulblets from the base of its upper roots. These can become clones that send up a single slender leaf when young, visible at the base of the mother plant. Each bulblet can mature into a separate plant to eventually form a group of crowded clones. Primula clevelandii never produces bulblets and thus does not produce a group of clones. Each plant is solitary and usually not crowded against others, unlike Primula hendersonii, where individuals are often found crowded together. In most of the lowland California floristic province, you can find one or both species of shooting stars to enjoy. For more information about the genus Primula, including a detailed look at the morphology of the flowers, please watch the video at this link.